about the Shunammite woman that she didn't give up. She told the manservant, she said, go get me an ass because I'm going to ride to the man of God. Oh, yes. So, and when she got on the ass, the Bible says she began to speak, it shall be well. In other words, I refuse to allow my situation to get the best of me. I refuse to allow the devil to play on my mind. Do you not know the devil? He come to steal, kill, and destroy. Oh, yes. So, you see what the devil does? You think you play on my mind? Because the devil knows that the body is controlled by the mind. And if you get in your mind, the whole body is subject to the mind. That's why, if you ever notice, as close you get to God, the devil will start messing with your mind. He'll start playing on your mind. Because the devil knows that what God is about to do in your life is great. Look at the neighbors. The neighbor, greatness is about to take his course. That's why he's trying to aggravate you. That's why he's trying to frustrate you. Oh, yes, because he don't want you to step into your destiny. But you got to tell the devil, say to the Lord, rebuke you. Whatever you're trying to do, it just won't work. Oh, yes. So the Bible goes on to say that the Shunammite woman, she began to speak in future tense. Oh, yes. So I know the Bible says that life and death is in the power of the tongue. As a man thinketh, so is he. If you think you defeat it, you've already defeated. But you got to learn to speak life over a dead situation. You got to speak to it. I'm reminded, oh yes, so, where the Bible says that he told the prophet, he said, now prophet, I need you to speak to these dried up bones. Ezekiel rather, he said, now Ezekiel, I need you to prophesy. It looked like a hopeless situation. Oh yes, so Ezekiel told the Lord, he said, Lord, you're the only one that can call these bones to come alive again. Ezekiel realized, he said, Lord, I'm helpless without you, Lord. You're the only one that can give life to a dead situation. But what Ezekiel did, he began to prophesy. I hear the Lord say, you got to learn to speak to your situation. You got to tell it, get up. Oh, yes, so be healed in the name of the Lord. You got to speak to it. Don't look at the neighbors. The neighbor, when was the last time you spoke to it? Hallelujah. God, hallelujah. And when you speak to it, it's got to get up. That's what the Bible says. What the man of God does, he begins to prophesy. And as he begins to prophesy to the bones, it looked like a hopeless situation. The bones were dried up bones, and there was no life there. But how many of you know we serve a God that can bring life to a dead situation? It doesn't matter what it looked like. God still can. Oh, yes. So, and as he began to prophesy, the Bible says there came a shaking in the valley. The bones begin to hook up. Oh, yes. So, praise God, as they begin to hook up, the Lord begin to allow sinew to come upon the bones. And then the Lord, he began to breathe breath into those dried up bones. And the Bible said that they became a living sacrifice. In other words, I hear the Lord say that your situation is just right for me. Hallelujah.